Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
NASCAR gets back at it Sunday at Las Vegas. It's the third race of the year, and after a week off, it could be just what several teams need to get back in the hunt. Casey Mears has a new crew chief in Darian Grubb. Darian joins Joe today from the shops of Hendrick Motorsports in Charlotte. Matt Kenseth is the most recent Nextel Cup winner and has two wins at Las Vegas. Can he do it again on Sunday? Those stories, our weekly fans forum, Mary Scully's point of view, and this week in Team Ford Racing, all next on Raceline. Brought to you by Mechanics Wear, the number one glove in NASCAR, and by Ford, bold moves, they happen every day.
NASCAR gets back into action on Sunday at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, the third race of the year for the Nextel Cup Series. For a lot of guys, it could be a turning point. Hi, everybody, I'm Joe Moore. Welcome to this week's edition of Raceline. Well, most of the Nextel Cup teams had a week to relax last week, although some of them went with us in the Busch Series down to Mexico City. We'll talk about that exciting race a little later on today on Raceline. But the Busch teams and Nextel Cup teams are moving into Las Vegas. Third race of the year for the Cup guys, fourth race of the year for the NASCAR Busch Series. Now, we talked last week about guys in trouble after two races this year. And boy, are they. Guys like Michael Waltrip, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Brian Vickers, Casey Kane, all names, big names, outside the top 30 in championship point standings. And this will be a very important race for them, a chance to turn around and sort of redeem themselves and get on the right track for the rest of the season. Another driver, not quite as bad as these guys, is Casey Mears. You know, he moved over to Hendrick Motorsports to drive the National Guard Chevrolet this year. After working for Chip Ganassi last year, he's 24th in the championship point standings. His crew chief, Darian Grubb, joins us today here on Raceline. Now, Darian, if you recall, was subbing for Chad Knaus last year after Chad was sent home after infractions at Daytona. And Darian directed Jimmy to a win at Daytona and a win in this race at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Darian joins us from the shops of Hendrick Motorsports down in Charlotte, North Carolina. Darian, you guys did well there at Las Vegas last year, picking up the victory, but things have changed at that racetrack since that time. Has it changed for the better?
It's definitely a whole different animal. The track, I think, is going to be really good for being able to go out and try something new. It's a new ground for everybody. He's got a new tire, new asphalt, whole new garage that we haven't even seen yet. So we're really looking forward to getting out there. I think it's going to be a great opportunity for everybody to kind of start fresh with the current cars we're racing today and go through, and be a good opportunity for this National Guard GMAC Chevrolet to go out and show what they've got.
Now, how does that change the way you guys prepare for the race on Sunday?
It changes a lot. The tires kind of throw a curveball to everybody, but everybody's kind of dealing with the same issue. So we're going to go out, we're planning to scuff tires and make adjustments to prepare for that and just do the best we can with what we give them.
Darian Grubb, crew chief for the National Guard Chevrolet of Casey Mears. We'll have more with Darian later today on Raceline.
Still to go today on Raceline. Tiffany talks about the controversial win by Juan Pablo Montoya last week in Mexico. And Matt Kenseth talks about Las Vegas. First, here's this week's championship points on our Mechanics Wear scoreboard. With all the latest NASCAR news with Joe on the radio. Catch NASCAR Today weekdays on your local MRN radio station. More of today's show right after this. On race day and every day, wear the tool that fits like a glove. Available at auto parts stores, Lowe's stores, and online at mechanics.com.
There's more to NASCAR racing than cars going in circles. Race Line takes you behind the action. Every week we go to the shops, to test sessions, and face-to-face with the biggest names in NASCAR racing. People make those cars perform, and we bring those people to you every week on Race Line with Joe Moore.
Welcome back to Raceline this week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo with a look at this week's news. Juan Pablo Montoya's win in Mexico City last week was very popular with the Hispanic crowd, but not too popular with Juan Pablo's teammate Scott Pruitt, whom Juan Pablo took out in the closing laps of the race. Another teammate at Ganassi Racing, David Stremme, spoke up for Juan Pablo, saying he's just a hard racer.
You know, he's been to Formula One, he's run that, he's been to kart and run, you know, at Indy, and now he's come over here to NASCAR and he's in drive a stock car. And I mean, I'm a race car driver. I'd go run a sprint car, or an open wheel car, whatever. I just love to compete. And the thing is I think he's seeing that our sport from the outside, and now he's come in, it's a lot different than what a lot of people take it for. It's a lot more competitive, as you heard him say. And I think throughout the year, he's going to get a lot better. And he's very rare compared to, say, I would say, some other open wheel drivers, because I've seen him run at Memphis, we were testing, at Lakeland, some of the short tracks, and he has such a knack for these cars. He's a really good guy to have as a teammate. You know, we were talking down to Daytona, and it was neat getting to listen to him describe things differently than what we had as far as our language and that. But probably the neatest thing is he's really upbeat. He's always, you know, outgoing and excited about what's going on, and he's never, like, thinking, well, you know, we're going to go out here and run 15th today. He wants to win. And I think he's going to make both Reed and myself see that and, you know, make us better.
Several sources indicate that the Busch Series will be back in Mexico City next year, although the three-year contract NASCAR had with the Mexico City track did expire with last week's running of the Telcel Motorola 200. The race did draw 72,000 fans. Mexico City is the world's second largest metropolis, and there were competitors from six different nations in the race. So NASCAR's thinking this might not be such a bad thing at all. David Reutimann is taking a big racing name to racing's highest level this year. Buzzy Reutimann was a huge name in short track racing, and David, driving for Michael Waltrip Racing, is taking the family into the Nextel Cup Series. Raceline's Steve Post has more.
One of the great drivers in the Ray Bestis Rookie of the Year field is David Reutimann, and race fans in the Northeast and race fans in the state of Florida know the last name very well. Buzzy Reutimann and Wayne Reutimann were tearing up the short tracks for years and years and actually continue to be strong short track racers. Buzzy's son David takes over the wheel of Michael Waltrip's Toyota going into this season, and for David, it's a chance to carry a very successful racing name on to higher heights.
Yeah, all my family at one level or another has had tremendous success and continues to have success. But I was just in the right place at the right time, got the opportunity, and actually just very, very blessed. And hopefully maybe this will open the doors for some more Reutimanns. I have some cousins and nephews that are showing a lot of talent, a lot of promise, and hopefully those guys will, maybe will slide in there and maybe make a name for themselves too, because they definitely got the talent.
So David Reutimann, coming from a famous family, and his father, Buzzy, still plays an integral and interesting role in David's development.
Well, he's never driven a cup car, but that doesn't stop him from telling me how to do it by any means. But my dad is a phenomenal guy, and he's at a lot of races with me, and we have a lot of fun together. And he's there to mainly keep me focused and keep me loosened up a little bit. Like at Daytona, he kept coming in and pulling the wind in it down, telling me to mash the pedal on the right, it'd go a little faster, you know. And that was kind of the, and we do that back and forth. When I go, you know, he's 66 years old, still races and still wins a lot of races. And when I go watch him, it's more of the same. I abuse him pretty bad too. So, but it's good to have him because he keeps things light and he keeps me focused and he keeps my grounded. You know, he'll be quick to tell me if I'm doing something I shouldn't be doing, and he's really good at that.
Great relationship between Buzzy Reutimann and his son David, as David carries on the famous 00 number and the famous last name, and it's going to be fun to watch as he races for the Ray Bestis Rookie of the Year honors this season.
Thanks, Steve. Reutemann was among several drivers testing at the Kentucky Speedway last week. Other drivers that were there included his teammates Dale Jarrett and Michael Waltrip. Martin Truex Jr. and Ryan Newman also tested at the track. The Kentucky Speedway is used a lot for Nextel Cup drivers testing because the layout is very similar to a lot of Nextel Cup tracks, but there is not a cup date at Kentucky Speedway. Well, two Busch Series drivers will attempt to make their first Nextel Cup starts this weekend at Las Vegas. John Wood is one of those young men. If he makes the race, he will be the first Wood in a Wood Brothers car since his grandfather drove in 1936. John says he knows the pressure is definitely on this weekend.
I don't know. I mean, you see these guys that make the jump and then they're there for just a split second and never heard from again. So it's almost like it's an easy ladder to climb, but you know it's not an easy one to stay on top of, and you only go straight down from there. So, I mean, it's just a very competitive sport.
Eric Almirola also plans to make his Nextel Cup debut this weekend if he qualifies for the race at Las Vegas. He'll be driving a Chevy out of the Joe Gibbs Racing stables. That's it for this week's news. I'm Tiffany Ricardo. More Raceline coming up right after this.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does.
He's not.
Are you going to get this?
Yes, it's awesome. You going to stand there and tell me that Dale Jr. runs better at Bristol than he does at the restriction plate tracks?
Well, he does.
Actually, Roger, she's correct. As you can see here, my average finish at Bristol is higher than either one of those tracks.
500 laps on Sunday isn't enough Bristol for Junior. That's why he's running the Sharpie Mini 300 Busch race on Saturday. Bristol Motor Speedway. Racing the way it ought to be.
I'm just saying.
Every May, they come to Charlotte for a man versus track showdown. 43 brave men convinced that they will be the one to tame the beast. Who will be a victim? Who will be the victor? Get your tickets now to see the beast awaken for the Coca-Cola 600, May 27th. Lowe's Motor Speedway at Charlotte, the beast of the Southeast.
Welcome back to this week's edition of Raceline as we get ready for the third race of the year at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. After that, it's off to the Atlanta Motor Speedway, followed by the first short track race of the year in Martinsville, Virginia. The schedule's starting to get a little busy. Darian Grubb is our special guest crew chief today. He works in the National Guard Chevrolet at Hendrick Motorsports for driver Casey Mears. Darian, let's talk about your job there. How is the chemistry in relationship coming together between you and Casey and the team?
The relationship's growing very well. We're really getting used to each other. We're talking a lot on the phone. We're making a lot of changes already with the way we run this race team and really getting comfortable with each other. We're going out to Camp Williams this week with National Guard near Salt Lake City to do some training exercises right along the sides of the National Guard troops there in Utah. So it's going to be a great experience for us to do team building and stuff ourselves. The entire National Guard GMAC Chevrolet team is going out there with us to do that. So it's going to be a great experience. So far, we've done very well. We really enjoyed it.
It looks like Casey Mears is fitting in well with the other drivers there at Hendrick Motorsports as well.
He does. They all have a great friendship and a great working relationship, and that is going to definitely help as we go through all our trials and tribulations here to build this team. It's going to be a great asset for us to be able to lean on those other players.
Thanks, Darian. We'll check back in with you later today here on Raceline.
This week in Team Ford Racing is brought to you by Ford. Bold moves.
David Gilliland is off to a good start in his first full season in the Nextel Cup Series. David was 8th at Daytona, 25th at California, and currently is just outside the top 10 and 11th going into Las Vegas. David says running the races at the end of last season really helped them get their act together this year.
Being able to run them last 14 races helped us a lot. We got to, evaluate our team, evaluate the personnel, evaluate the cars. Everything. And by the end of the year, we built some new cars and really felt like we took a big, big step in the right direction. And I'm very thankful that I was able to do that because, I mean, I learned a lot as a driver, too. I think I built some respect with other drivers, being able to race around them and not causing any problems and everything else. So it's very happy. You know, I mean, I think, like I said, we've earned some respect and got our program better. So definitely we're way further ahead now than we would have been if I had just started. So, and I have a lot of confidence in that.
And David is glad to have a veteran like Ricky Rudd as a teammate.
It means the world to me. I mean, to have somebody like that to bounce, you know, my ideas off of and ask questions is something that, you know, the average person you can't buy or get, you know. And Ricky's been 100% open book to me, anything I need, you know. And it's just, I can't even tell you how much it means to me. And it's been so great. This morning I was asking him questions, you know, as far as how the car should be, you know, in qualifying trim compared to race trim and everything else. So he's really answered a lot of questions for me. That's why he's here today, just for me to bounce ideas off of and questions. And I got a lot of them, especially, you know, at these tracks that I haven't raced on. So he's been able to help me a lot, and I'm really looking forward to working with him throughout the year.
The bad news about those 14 races is that it used up David's rookie eligibility, but that doesn't seem to bother him.
I have a Rookie of the Year trophy at home, and it don't mean anything to me. It sits up there and collects dust, you know what I mean? I want to win a race, and to better our chances of winning a race, we had to run them last 14 races and get our team and program back. Otherwise, we would have been 14 races into this season, and you know, who knows what would have happened. So, like I said, I feel really good about our downforce program. At Homestead, we had a great run. Our restrictor plate program is very good. And our car tomorrow, so we've been doing a lot of testing on. So I feel really good about our overall program right now.
Find out more of what's going on in Ford Racing and join the fun at Team Ford Racing. Find out more at FordRacing.com. More of today's Raceline right after this.
You know you love NASCAR. Don't just watch it, live it. Get hands-on training in the heart of NASCAR country at NASCAR Technical Institute. NTI's industry-specific automotive technology program and its NASCAR performance technology programs deliver the horsepower to accelerate your rewarding new career.
Everything is authentic. Everything we do here applies to the NASCAR world.
Built on 40 years of automotive training excellence and strong NASCAR automotive industry relationships, NTI's programs deliver.
It's a first-class operation. Right now we have six guys from NTI that work here, and they work here in various places.
Complete your training in about a year. All NTI graduates receive employment assistance.
Yeah, we're constantly looking. We have 340 employees. You've got to be well-educated to work on a race team today.
Trained NASCAR, performance racing, and automotive technicians are in high demand. Call NTI now and turn your passion into a new career.
Welcome back to this week's edition of Raceline. It's time to announce some winners of our ticket contest for Bristol coming up in a couple of weeks. Lisa Justice from Westminster, South Carolina, and Michael McCabe of Jonesboro, Tennessee, won tickets to the Sharpie Mini 300 in Bristol. Our grand prize winner getting tickets to that race and the sold-out Food City 500 is Brian George from College Park, Maryland. Congratulations, folks. We'll see you at Bristol. By the way, you can still buy tickets to the Sharpie Mini 300 at bristolmotorspeedway.com. Now let's see what Mary Scully's thinking about today on our Racing Milestones Point of View.
At the NASCAR Nextel Cup Media Tour, hosted by Lowe's Motor Speedway in late January, the emphasis was on winning. Brian France said he didn't want drivers to be excited about finishing second. Humpy Wheeler said much the same thing. To echo Vince Lombardi, winning is everything. Nowhere was that more apparent than at the Petty Enterprises shop in Level Cross, North Carolina. The mood was upbeat, and it was clear that these teams are on their way back up. Both Kyle Petty and Bobby Labonte finished last season in the top 35 in points, so there is no sweat about making the first five races of the year. And while other teams call the car of tomorrow the great unknown, the Pettys have embraced it and are ready for 16 races this season. Kyle was very involved in the development of this safer race car, and there was a twinkle in his eye as he talked about it. It's clear that he and Bobby Labonte believe they have a handle on it. We've done a lot of testing with the car of tomorrow. We want to kick everybody's butt in Bristol. I have to hand it to Richard Petty. He'll be 70 years old in July and has seen more changes in the sport than all the press members on the media tour put together. But he's willing to change with the times. It would be great to see a team with such long tradition be the first in victory lane with the car of tomorrow. Kyle, I hope you do kick everybody's butt at Bristol. I'm Mary Scully, editor of Racing Milestones magazine, and that's my point of view.
Mary Scully's point of view brought to you by Sports Gear Racing. Rusty Wallace is back, not in a race car, but in the announcer's booth as the star analyst for ESPN. Rusty is the cover boy of this special Racing Milestones TV issue, now on sale at Auto Trader racks in gas marts and convenience stores nationwide.
Last week's Fans Forum here on Raceline was about the engine problems many teams had at California Speedway a couple of weeks ago. It was the first race where the Nextel Cup Series ran the unleaded fuel. We ask you if that was the reason they had the engine problems. Here's the answer we chose as this week's winner. David Booth of Hanover, Pennsylvania says, yes, the unleaded fuel apparently threw a curveball at some of the teams and adjusting to the lack of additional lube or cushioning provided by the lead additive. The race teams were obviously aware of this issue, but I think the lack of actual race condition data combined with a notorious engine killer track like California seemingly made it difficult for some of them to properly adjust to. Very good answer, Dave. We'll send you our Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Now this week's question. What do you think of Juan Pablo's pass for the win last week in Mexico City?
Answer this week's Fans Forum question and we'll send you a great Mechanics Wear gift pack and a year subscription to Racing Milestones. Just go to our website at RaceLineOnline.com. More of today's show right after this.
Every May, they come to Charlotte for a man versus track showdown. 43 brave men convinced that they will be the one to tame the beast. Who will be a victim? Who will be the victor?
Get your tickets now to see the Beast Awaken for the Coca-Cola 600, May 27th. Lowe's Motor Speedway at Charlotte,
the Beast of the Southeast.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does.
He's not.
Are you going to get this?
Yes, it's awesome. You going to stand there and tell me that Dale Jr. runs better at Bristol than he does at the restriction plate tracks?
Well, he does.
Actually, Roger, she's correct. As you can see here, my average finish at Bristol is higher than either one of those tracks.
500 laps on Sunday isn't enough Bristol for Junior. That's why he's running the Sharpie Mini 300 Busch race on Saturday. Bristol Motor Speedway. Racing the way it ought to be.
I'm just saying.
Getting ready for Las Vegas coming up on Sunday, the third race of the year. Our special guest, the winning crew chief from last year, Darian Grubb, then subbing for Chad Knaus, now full-time crew chief for Casey Mears in the National Guard Chevrolet. Darian, you've been with Hendrick Motorsports for some time now, but in a different role. We just talked about last year when you subbed for Chad Knaus. Do you think that experience is what ultimately led to this position being offered to you?
I think it definitely helped. It's one of those times where I really was able to step up and take the opportunity that was given to me and do the best with it. The team was great that I was working with there, so the strength of the National Guard GMAC Chevrolet team we have here goes along with the same issues, the same attitude going into the racetrack and stuff that we had there, so I really think we have a great chance for success. And going into Las Vegas this weekend, Casey's never finished out of the top 15 there in a cup car, and he has three straight top 10, so we're really looking forward to building on that this weekend.
How much different is this job from your role as team engineer, and does that background help in this position?
I definitely think that background really helps. It's a lot different job. I was still doing a lot of the same changes, or at least recommending the same changes to Chad when I was over there as an engineer with the 24 and the 48 teams. It's a lot of the same issues, a lot of the same work at the racetrack, but now I'm actually the guy in charge. I have to listen to my engineers give me the same feedback so I can form my opinions and make the right calls. But it's that background that I have to lean on, the people I have here in the motorsports and the resources we have. I don't think I'm lacking for anything in this position.
Darian, thanks for being with us today, and hope you guys have good luck at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Now it's time for us to make our picks here on Raceline. Last week, we were all three in the top 10 in Mexico City. At Las Vegas, Jimmie Johnson won the last two races. Matt Kenseth won the two races before that. Tiffany, you think we'll see a first-time winner this week?
Joe, I think there is going to be a new winner this week, but it's someone who's very familiar to the Las Vegas crowd. I think it's going to be Kyle Busch, hometown boy. He's won at California, which is kind of a similar track. He's really good on tracks like that. And he finished third at Las Vegas last year. And I think, for some reason, I have a feeling this team is going to be really good this year. So I'm going with Kyle Busch at Las Vegas.
All right, one vote for Kyle Busch. What do you think, Mike?
Well, you guys, I'm going to make this one easy. I'm going to go with the guy that's won this race the last two times, and I think third time's a charm. Hey, Jimmie Johnson seems to have control over this place that he has for the last 2 years. So I am going to go with Jimmie Johnson to go to Victory Lane this weekend in Las Vegas.
Well, Mike, I'm going to go with a guy who's also won two times at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. It's Matt Kenseth. Picked up the wins there in 03 and 04. Remember how good Fords are at that track. They've won more than any other make in the 9 years we've been racing there. And Matt's the most recent Nextel Cup winner, picking up the victory at California Speedway a couple of weeks ago. So my vote is with Matt Kenseth. So we're picking Jimmie Johnson, Matt Kenseth, or Kyle Busch to win at Vegas. I think they're pretty safe picks. We'll find out. Hope you can join us again next week right here on Raceline.
Raceline is brought to you by Mechanics Wear, the number one glove in NASCAR. By Ford, bold moves. Also by MRN Radio, the voice of NASCAR. And by Fast Track, the weekly NASCAR news leader. Find out more about our sponsors and contact us at the Raceline website at racelineonline.com. Watch past editions of Raceline anytime on the World Wide Web. Just go to racelineonline.com and link to the Auto Channel. Closed captioning on Raceline provided by Racing Milestones.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.